Hello and welcome to this video. We will discuss one special property of a kernel of a one-to-one linear transformation. This result is formulated in the theorem 2.4. It says that if T is a linear transformation, then T can be one-to-one if and only if its kernel consists only of one vector, which is a zero vector. We will look at the proof. This is if and only if statement. So we have to prove it both directions, and we will start in this direction. Given that T is one to one, we will prove that kernel consists only of a zero vector. Since T is a linear transformation, we know that T of zero vector is always a zero vector. We knew that zero vector is always in the kernel. However, we also know that T is one to one. And from this, we can conclude that there is no other non-zero vector x such that T of x is zero. Because from the fact that T is one to one, it follows that all vectors are transformed into different vectors. And if zero vector transformed to zero vector, then no other vector can be transformed also to zero vector. Therefore, we conclude that our kernel consists only of one vector, which is the zero vector. Now we'll prove in the opposite direction. Given is that kernel consists only of a zero vector, and we have to prove that T is one to one. And we will prove it by contradiction. Assume that T of x is W and T of y is W for some x and y in V. Then we can use the standard way of proving uniqueness. We subtract tx minus ty, and that will be w minus w, and that will be zero. So now we have this equality, and from this equality we want to conclude that necessarily x should be equal to y. How do we do that? We can use the property of a linear transformation. Then we can write that tx minus ty is t of x minus y. And that was equal to the zero vector. Now we can notice that x minus y is a vector of which transformation is equal to zero vector. What does it mean? It means that x minus y is in the kernel. However, kernel consists only of one vector, which is the zero vector. And that means that x minus y equals to zero vector, and that means that x is equal to y. So we started with the assumption that there are two vectors in V which transform into the same vector W, and we arrive to the conclusion that actually these two vectors are the same. And that means that the transform is one to one. And that completes the proof. This is a very easy proof. This is kind of a proof that can be asked at an exam. What I want to pay your attention to is the following. Recall that I told you that the notion of a one-to-one transformation does not necessarily apply to a linear transformation. It can be applied to any type of transformations. However, for this particular result, we did need the linearity. We needed it both times. When we prove in this direction, then from the fact that transformation is linear, we concluded that zero is transformed to zero. And when we are proving the opposite direction, then we use here the property that the transformation is linear. Then we could write this equality. And if our transformation was not linear, then maybe we couldn't write that. I want to pay again your attention that all conditions of theorems are very important and that linear transformations are special. In general, this theorem is not difficult. Students like to use it very much in solving problems. I hope that this theorem and its proof was clear. Thank you very much for your attention.